JQ with Tech Creation, what's going on? So this is my first time reviewing a smart TV and I don't want to waste any time. This is the UN55KS8000 by Samsung. It's a 55-inch SUHD 4K smart LED LCD television with a pixel count of 3840 by 2160. It's running Samsung's Tizen OS and it's also available at 49 inches, 60 inches, and 65 inches as well. So right away you'll notice a slim profile that tapers only about 1.7 inches outward, along with its beautiful thin bezels, or lack thereof I should say. I always appreciate a greater screen real estate. It immerses you a bit more when you kick back, and it still looks sexy even when the screen is off. You have a gorgeous silver accent laid across the entire front, and then you have your Samsung logo smack in the middle that lights up when it's on. This complements the stylish chrome leg stands, which are easy on the eyes, I might add. They slide in, securing it into place with a great amount of tolerance. There's no wobbling of any sort, and in this particular model, they can only be fixed to this one position, but on the larger models, you have more playroom where you can affix them either wide or narrow. This television is HDR10 ready, and more on that later, and it comes equipped with built-in Wi-Fi, but I happen to be hardwired into the Ethernet port that's found on the back, so there's no buffering allowed. And speaking of connectivity, what makes this panel so thin is that Samsung moved all of its ports to its One Connect box, which scratches pretty easy by the way, but it houses your HDMI, coaxial, USB, and optical audio ports, which you then connect to the television via Samsung's proprietary One Connect cable. So setting up the TV was pretty easy. The automatic input detection was a huge help. It did a fantastic job in picking up and labeling my components connected via HDMI, and it saved me the hassle of having to manually rename the inputs. It comes with a tiny remote with a stylish bend to it. It really shows Samsung's obsession with curves. It feels comfortable in the hand, it's lightweight, it looks cool, and it picks up oil from your fingertips, but I found it easy to clean nonetheless. There's not too much going on here in terms of button layout. You have your home button, your back button, your select, your volume buttons, channel, and some other interface buttons that are satisfying to click, I might add. Very OCD friendly. There's also a small microphone up top for voice control, similar to what competitors offer, and this works by pressing down the mic, saying the command, and then releasing it when you're done. For example, like, increase volume by X amount. It can be a bit particular with phrases sometimes, but nonetheless, it picked up my voice surprisingly well, even with a little bit of noise in the background. So Tizen OS is simple and clean with Samsung's Smart Hub. You'll find your usual apps like Netflix, YouTube, Amazon Video, and a bunch of other third-party apps and services like Plex, Hulu, Crackle, HBO Go, and Spotify would have been a nice addition, but sadly it's not supported. But then again, that's what Chromecast is around for. Now what's cool about this is you can download games with your Samsung account and begin playing titles like Asphalt. Granted, the graphics are kinda lame, but aside from that, you can use the directional buttons and the remote to play, which is a little awkward, so do yourself a favor and use a USB or Bluetooth gaming controller instead. Also, if you're a Gamefly or PlayStation Now subscriber, you can take advantage of those services as well. Now, this will not replace your gaming consoles, but it's nice to have around to entertain the kids or guests, if that's your kind of thing. Now, onto the menus, they're pretty simple, with a bunch of settings that you can tweak to your liking for sound and picture, most of which are just digital enhancements that I'd recommend not tampering with too much. For example, this TV has what's called Motion Rate 240 that incorporates some sort of video processing and backlight scanning to improve the overall clarity of moving images. And it does this in conjunction with Auto Motion Plus, which is a built-in software engine that generates additional frames to effectively reduce motion blur. Now, some don't like the smooth video, what they call the soap opera effect, and some do. It's definitely not suited for all types of content, I'll tell you that. But it's great for animations though. I personally just like to leave it on auto and call it a day. So Samsung's SUHD panels use quantum dot technology, which briefly put means colors are less filtered, which result in pure whites, producing brighter and much more accurate, vibrant colors. And let me just tell you, this TV looks beautiful. 4K footage is lifelike, it's sharp as hell. The colors really pop with just the right amount of saturation in my opinion. And even 1080p content looks pretty good with its built-in 4K upscaling. There were a few reflections here and there, but nothing that took away from my enjoyment. And I will admit though, sometimes I felt the whites were a little too bright for my taste at times. So I had to set the smart LED feature to low, and that took care of that. So this panel is equipped with HDR 1000, which is Samsung's way of saying HDR 10. So HDR 10 is the more common standard for HDR televisions, where the displays peak at 1000 nits of brightness, which is 10 times greater than conventional televisions, giving you a greater range of brightness to work with, resulting in heightened contrast in images. Now the problem here is there isn't too much content shot in HDR10, and the same goes for the other HDR standard called Dolby Vision to really take advantage of an HDR TV, you know what I mean? Now the other problem is Netflix and Amazon Video stream both HDR standards, however, good luck finding titles. In addition, you must be paying for Netflix's premium 4-screen / Ultra HD plan to even begin getting HDR titles. And I'll be all the way honest with you guys, the difference in imagery with HDR content and non-HDR content is not something the average Joe would probably even notice nor even care about. I mean, I'm not too crazy about it myself. Maybe as the technology matures a little more and becomes more available. And lastly, my only problem with 4K televisions is that my cable provider still doesn't broadcast 4K content.